Good evening. It's good to be with you this evening. This is our Ascension Day service. We normally would be outside Burton Overy, half of us up the tower and half of us on the bottom. But as you can understand, we aren't able to do that this evening. So what I would like to do is share with you what we call an agape meal. So we're going to have some scripture reading and some hymns during this, but we'd also like to share at the end an agape meal, and that simply means what the disciples did. They met in each other's houses and they shared the bread and the wine and remembered Jesus. So it's not that I'm not blessing the bread and the wine. It's simply us sharing a meal together, albeit virtually today. So hopefully the liturgy will be on the screen for you when the time comes. And there's responses, which you will hear the voice of Isaac responding and helping me with this. So let us now begin our service. God has gone up with a shout.
The Lord with the sound of a trumpet.
Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, for 40 days we have been celebrating with joyful hearts the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, his bursting from the tomb and his defeat of the power of sin and death. He appeared to his disciples many times and told them about the kingdom of heaven. Today we recall how he left this earth and returned to his Father, ascending to heaven to take his throne over all the dominions and powers, trusting in his reign over all creation and submitting to his kingly yet loving rule. Let us hear the story of his parting.
We're going to sing Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise.
Good morning. This is the New Testament reading taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, verses 4 to 11, the Ascension of Jesus. While Jesus was staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now." So when they had come together, they asked him, "Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel?" He replied, "It is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up towards heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you to heaven, will come in the same way you saw him go into heaven." This ends the reading of the Acts of the Apostles. Amen.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
So our prayer for this evening. Risen Christ, you have raised our human nature to the throne of heaven. Help us to seek and serve you, that we may join you at the Father's side, when you reign with the Spirit, where you reign with the Spirit in glory, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
I'll now ask Isaac to come and do our gospel reading in Luke.
Alleluia, alleluia. Go and make disciples of all nations, says the Lord. Remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age. Alleluia. Luke chapter 24, verses 44 to the end. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I have spoken to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven, and they worshipped him. And they returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they're continually in the temple blessing God.
So we've just heard of the scripture of Jesus ascending into heaven. I think it's very interesting scripture to dwell on at this time. It was only through Jesus ascending that we received the Holy Spirit. It is the very thing we need through to take us through this difficult time. The disciples had to let Jesus go, and that brought great sorrow, I'm sure. But it also, the scripture says, brought them great joy at the same time. Jesus had to go so that they could continue the work that he had begun. Jesus had taught them all they needed to do to continue that work. Once the Holy Spirit came, they were equipped to do all that he had called them to do. Now, a couple thousand years later, we come to a place of remembering that the Lord ascended this day and what it means to us. We received the Holy Spirit when we became believers in Jesus' death and resurrection. We have the same power the Holy Spirit breathed on those first believers, the tongues of fire and the wind of the Spirit. Jesus has given us what we need to go through what he has called us to do. We have the Holy Spirit there to help us when we don't know how to pray. The scripture says that he intercedes on our behalf and gives us words when we don't have the words to say. He guides us and shows us the way through. He is the light in our path and the voice in our hearts if we let him work in and through us. So wherever you are today, if you're in a good place, then take time to make sure you say thank you to God for his goodness and all that he has done for you. If you're in a hard place, then let the Holy Spirit be your guide through the valley until you find your way back to the light. The best thing to do when you don't know what the next step forward is to ask the Holy Spirit to show you the way and trust that he will guide your every step and help you find the way through this. The Spirit is the greatest gift the Lord has given us. So let us receive that gift and allow him to work in our lives. Amen. So as we reflect on the Holy Spirit and all that he does for us, let us take a moment to pray. Let us join our prayers with those of our Savior Jesus Christ, seeking Father's blessing and the gifts of the Spirit. Jesus Christ, great high priest, living forever to intercede for us, pray for the church, your broken body throughout the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Jesus Christ, King of righteousness, enthroned at the right hand of majesty on high, pray for the world and make it subject to your gentle rule. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Jesus Christ, Son of Man, drawing humanity into the life of God, pray for your brothers and sisters in need, distress, or sorrow. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Jesus Christ, pioneer of our salvation, bringing us to glory through your death and resurrection, surrounded with your saints and angels, those who have died trusting your promises. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Jesus Christ, Lord, over all things, ascended far above the heavens and filling the universe, pray for us who have received the gifts you give, for the work in your service. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Jesus Christ, keep the church in the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace, and bring the whole created order to worship at your feet. For you are alive and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
So now we say the words of the peace. So if you're with someone, do give them a hug or a handshake or whatever you feel is right. Because Jesus says, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. If you love me, rejoice because I am going to the Father. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So take a moment now to share with the people in your household. So we now come to the part where we have the agape meal. So hopefully you have bread with you and a drink. It doesn't have to be wine, it could be juice, it could be whatever you feel is right, but a type of bread and a type of juice. And we will go through this together as the disciples did way back 2,000 years ago, where they shared a meal together and broke bread. So out of darkness came light.
All the power of God was revealed in the running wave and the flowing air, in the quiet earth and the shining stars.
Out of the dust came life.
and the image of God was revealed in the human face and the gentle heart, in the warmth of flesh and the depth of soul.
Out of justice came freedom.
And the wisdom of God was revealed in the need to grow and the will to love, in the chance to know and the power to choose.
And God looked at creation, and behold, it was good. Good. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be continually in my mouth. We say together, I will keep on thanking God with constant words of prayer. I will glory in the living God. The humble will hear and be glad. So let us pray. Living God, our loving parent, you cherish your creation, and we praise you with earth, air, water, and fire. In our element as your children, we praise you. With our lips, with our lives, in all our diversity, each one made in your image, we praise you. Because in Jesus, you came to share our human lives, our sorrow and our joy, we praise you. Because your Spirit is at work today, encouraging, enabling, surprising us, we praise you. Poor as we are, you give us hope. Salt of the earth, you give us meaning and purpose, and we praise you. Amen. So now our prayer of confession. Please respond in the words in bold. Salt is good, but if salt has lost its saltiness, how can you season it again?
Giving God, you blessed us with saltiness, but we became bland.
You trusted us with your word,
but we did not keep it.
You lit a flame in our midst,
but we hid it under formality, smothered it with our fears.
God, in your mercy,
forgive us.
Forgiving God, we believe that you have called us
to be salt and light,
that you offer us time and space and strength
to begin again.
Giving and forgiving God,
we thank you.
Have salt in yourselves and be at peace with one another. Amen. So taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who take refuge in him. So this is a time where we come to the sharing of the feast. We're invited to the common table to share in this agape feast. At the table we come as brothers and sisters in the holy family of God. Taste and see that God is good. So if you have a piece of bread, we share this bread. And we pour out this wine, and we thank you, God, for our daily bread, for food which delights and nourishes us, and for the championship that sustains, the companionship that sustains us. So the body of Christ, broken for you, let us share the feast together. We thank you too for the wine to quench our thirst, and for the living water which you surprise and enrich and transform our lives. We give thanks for this feast at which we can share a foretaste of the holy realm. Amen. The body of Christ, or the blood of Christ shed for you. So let us now say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So we respond together. As the disciples waited in the upper room, so we wait for the refreshing of the Spirit. As we wait in silence,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we listen to your word,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we worship you in majesty,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your refreshing,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your renewing,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your equipping,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your empowering,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
We'll now sing, Strength Will Rise.
Upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise, we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. Our hope, our strong we Lord, we will wait upon the Lord.
So I pray that God be with you as we begin this season working towards Pentecost, that he may bless you, that the Holy Spirit will guide you through whatever it is you're facing, whether it be good or difficult, that you know the power of the Spirit in your life. So final blessing. May the Spirit who set the church on fire upon the day of Pentecost bring the world alive with the love of the risen Christ, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Waiting expectantly for the promised Holy Spirit, go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.